Hello, 3D printing friends. Today on the BV3D channel, we're going to take a look at Sunlu PLA Plus filament. Stick around and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi everyone, welcome back. So today we're taking a look at Sunlu PLA Plus filament. This is the blue-gray color. I got this filament on Amazon using a 20% off discount code that Sunlu had on Twitter. The price of this filament at the time of purchase was US$18.99 for a 1 kilogram spool. After the discount code, it was $15.19. Now sometimes pricing on Amazon changes day to day. On this particular product, I've seen the price ranging from $17.99 to about $19.99, and that puts it in the lower mid-range for PLA filament prices. I want to mention from the start of this that I don't think Sunlu's recent shenanigans on Twitter are in their best interests. They've been desperately trying to get people to try this filament and post reviews on Amazon, but the way they're going about it is kind of sketchy. See, one of the ways that companies get products reviewed is to provide the product at no cost to a reviewer. Now, I don't see that as a bad thing. You may argue that because a reviewer got something free, they might want to protect that relationship by only saying nice things about the product. Personally, I think most reviewers put integrity above freebies because, frankly, a reviewer's duty is to their audience. If you're not honest with your audience, pretty soon you won't have one. But what Sunlu proposed to myself and others on Twitter is that we buy the filament, provide a review on Amazon, and then Sunlu would reimburse us the cost of the purchase via PayPal. And that sounded sketchy. Would Sunlu reimburse you if you left a mediocre review? What about a bad review? The reviewer would be completely at Sunlu's mercy for reimbursement. Now, it sort of sounds like Sunlu is trying to buy favorable Amazon reviews, and that's probably against Amazon's terms of service. Sunlu is likely doing this so the Amazon reviews are from a verified purchaser. The concept of verified purchaser indicates that the reviewer is a person who has received and used the product being sold, rather than from someone who hasn't. But if Sunlu wants Amazon reviews from verified Amazon purchasers, they could offer a reviewer a 99% off coupon code. The reviewer gets the filament for almost free, and any review on Amazon is from a verified purchaser. Not only that, but the reviewer is free to leave an honest review without worrying that a negative review would cause Sunlu to back out of their deal. Anyway, I'm hoping Sunlu gets their act together. For my part in all this, as I mentioned earlier, I used a 20% off coupon that Sunlu made available on Twitter. But I'm not looking for reimbursement from Sunlu. I don't want to be a party to some sketchy deal. But enough about Sunlu's shenanigans. We're here to talk about Sunlu's filament. If you've seen my other filament reviews, you'll know that I want to find out how the filament performs in certain key areas. So I use a testing method that I think provides a fair assessment of a filament's performance. The first thing I print is a temperature tower with a temperature range appropriate for the filament. This allows me to see how the filament performs across a range of temperatures. I then choose the temperature that gave the best looking result and print a suite of models to further test it. A bridging test file shows how well the filament bridges unsupported gaps. A stringing slash retraction test shows the filament's resistance to stringing when using my standard retraction settings. Daniel Nare's 3D Benchy tests a whole pile of things, including overhangs, small bridges, and surface finish on curves, and it's both a fun and common model to print. I also print a Calicat calibration model to get an idea of the surface finish on boxy models, and also because it's a cat, and also because my wife says I've printed way too many Benchies. I know I say that every time, but it's true. And I print the Aria Dragon, designed by Louise Driggers, because dragons are cool. All her dragons were meant to be calibration objects, and Aria is a good dragon to print. She tests a nice variety of things, stringing, overhangs, fine pointy bits, and reproduction of details, and you can see the surface finish on a more organic model. So that's the test suite. Let's talk about how the filament is packaged, and then we'll get into how it performs. The filament comes enclosed in a cardboard box with a label indicating the type, diameter, weight, and color. On the back of the box, the diameter tolerance, shown in large type, plus or minus 0.02 millimeters, and there is a table listing the temperature ranges for all of Sunlu's filament products. Inside the box, the filament is vacuum sealed with a desiccant pack in a non-resealable bag. I prefer resealable bags, but only about half the filament I buy includes them. The filament is on a plastic spool, and the spool carries a label with much of the same information as the label on the box. It omits the weight, but includes the printing temperature range, which is nice to have on the spool itself. One of the things that attracted me to this filament was the precise winding of the filament on the spool. I think the only other spool I've ever owned that was wound this way was the gray filament from Prusa, which came with my Mark III kit a year or so ago. Now, Sunlu's marketing this as a tangle-free filament, and with a precision wind like this, it's hard to imagine any sort of overlap or tangle. I'm curious to see whether this winding stays like this down through the rest of the spool. The spool is not marked with a recycling symbol, so you can't just toss it in the recycle bin when you use the last of the filament. But you can keep them around to load filament samples onto. Interestingly, the recommended temperature range for this filament varies depending on where you look. The Amazon listing says to print between 210 degrees C and 240 degrees C in one place, and 190 degrees C and 230 degrees C in another. The table on the back of the box says to print between 205 degrees C and 230 degrees C, and the spool itself says to print between 190 C and 230 C. I would tend to trust the label on the spool the most, but of course the temperature tower will show which temperature will work the best on my printer. Well, now that we know how the filament is packaged, let's find out how it performs. Here's the temperature tower I printed. Overall, it printed really well across the entire temperature range from 235 degrees C down to 195 degrees C. Overhang performance was mostly okay, but there's some slight curling evident on them. Its ability to bridge gaps on this test was good across all temperatures. Based on the results from the temperature tower, I decided to print the rest of the test suite at 220 degrees C. All the models were printed on a Prusa Mark III printer and sliced with Prusa Slicer. Apart from the temperature tower, all the models were printed with a 220 degree nozzle on a 60 degree bed. I sliced these using Prusa Slicer's 0.2mm quality setting. This uses a 0.2mm layer height, 15% infill, and a speed of 45mm per second. And it slices using two perimeters, four top layers and five bottom layers. Let's take a look at the results. Here is the bridging test. The Sunlu PLA Plus performance is very good on all the bridges. The longest bridge spans nearly 52 millimeters, and there was a slight bit of sagging, but all the layers are still touching, so its ability to bridge gaps without supports is good. I did notice wispy stringing between nearly all of the columns on this bridge test, but the strings are very, very fine. Now here's the retraction slash stringing test. The columns are straight, but there is significant stringing on this model. Next is Daniel Nare's 3D Benchy. The Sunlu PLA Plus produced a pretty good benchy. The overhang angles on the bow printed without issue. The fine details in the wheelhouse turned out well. The doorway arches had a little trouble at the top, but the overall surface finish is nice. There is a slight bit of stringing, but it's really quite minimal, and the smokestack printed with no issues. On to the Calicat. This turned out pretty well. On this model, the filament likes to curl on overhangs, which shows up most noticeably on the left side of the tail. This curling also shows up on the 45 degree overhangs in the corners of the neck of the cat. Apart from that, the surface finish is smooth, and I saw only two small strings on this model between the tail and the body. Now it's time for the Aria Dragon by Louise Driggers. The base looks pretty good, and the detail on the toes looks good. The legs look a little rough though, and there's some stringing there. The back of the dragon looks smooth, but the backs of the wings look a bit rough. This roughness is due to the curling on the overhangs, which was also observed on the Calicat. The neck and head came out really good. The stringing between the wings is apparent, but it's not as pronounced as on the stringing test. The consistency is that of cobwebs and would be easily removed by pinching and pulling or the brief application of a heat gun. So here are the test suite results, printing the models at 220 degrees C on a 60 degrees C bed. The bridging performance was very good with minimal sagging. The stringing performance was rather stringy on the test print. The Benchy performance was very good, the Calicat performance was good, and the Aria performance was good. Overall, I feel this is an adequate filament for the price. Its performance is good. However, with its stringing issues and its tendency to curl on overhangs, this is a filament you're going to have to play with to find the sweet spot for your printer's settings. For functional prints, this filament is good, but if you're printing detailed models, you're going to be spending a lot of time fine-tuning your retraction and temperature settings. clearing out the cobwebs and dealing with rough edges on overhangs, or doing a lot of post-processing on the prints. In the process of making this video, I tried adjusting temperatures and retraction to get the curling and stringing under control. My usual retraction settings on this printer is the default of 0.8 millimeters. I printed the stringing test model several times, gradually increasing the retraction. I more than doubled the retraction, and I didn't see any improvement with stringing. Likewise, I printed calicats at every temperature on the temperature tower and couldn't get rid of the curling on the tail's overhangs. Now, this filament has a lot going for it. I spot-checked its diameter, and it was always within the stated plus or minus 0.02 millimeter tolerance. That's impressive. And I like this filament's blue-gray color, and I appreciate the care taken when winding the filament. And that winding carries on down through the spool, which also impresses me. If you're willing to put in the time, you may find it gives you good results. If you want a filament you can just load and go with your usual settings, you may be disappointed. It's definitely not unusable. For some models, it prints really well. Others, not so much. It can be a challenge to get it dialed in, but quite frankly, there are so many other filaments available that just print without having to fiddle with settings that I would have a hard time recommending this. So if I had to give this filament a star rating, I would give it 3 out of 5. And thus ends the testing and review of Sunlu's Blue-Grey PLA Plus filament. And now we're at the end of the video. If you made it this far, thank you. And a big thanks to those of you who subscribe, like, comment on, and share these videos. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If not, give it a thumbs down. But either way, leave your thoughts down in the comments. If you like the content I'm producing and want to support what I do, consider supporting the channel with a one-time micropayment. You could buy me a coffee or leave a little something in the PayPal tip jar. You can also support the channel by using my affiliate links when you're shopping around online. I've got links into Amazon, GearBest, and WhamBam systems, and using them doesn't cost you anything. And if you buy something from one of those retailers when you go in through that link, they'll kick a tiny percentage of that back to the channel. Links for all that stuff are down in the description. Well, now that all this is done, I'm going to go print something cool. You do the same, and I'll see you next time.